Drones are the one of the amazing inventions of the 21st century. But do you know how and where it came from? Do you know that there are different types of drones for different applications? If you don't, just chill. Because in this video, we will see the revolution of drone technology and enjoy learning it. So, without any further delay, let's jump straight into it. So, what is actually a drone? According to various dictionaries, a drone tends to be defined as an aircraft that does not have a pilot but is controlled by someone on the ground, used especially for dropping bombs or for surveillance. A drone in technological term is also defined as a flying robot that can be remotely controlled or fly autonomously through software-controlled flight plans in their embedded system, working in conjunction with onboard sensors and GPS. Although originally built for military purposes, drones have seen a rapid growth and advancements and made a breakthrough to consumer electronics. Today, drones are used for a wide range of functions, including monitoring climate change, delivering goods, aiding in search and rescue operations, and in filming and photography. According to the Federal Aviation Administration, there were 1.1 million drones registered in the US in 2019. Well, this is seriously amazing. Let's quickly look at some history of drone technology in an adventurous way. The concept of drone was first attempted date back to 1849 when Austria attacked Venice, the beautiful city of Italy, using unmanned balloons stuffed with explosives. Austrian forces, who surrounded themselves with armed forces against Venice at that time, launched around 200 of these incendiary balloons over the city. Each balloon carried anywhere between 24 to 30 pounds of bomb. Fortunately for the Venetians, only one bomb found its mark, as most of the balloons were blown off course due to the sudden change in wind direction. That being said, it is very interesting to see the basic concept of drone was being considered by military technologists more than 170 years ago. Later, one of the first quadcopters appeared in the early 1900s, which looked like this, but it also doesn't stand as they expected. After the advancement in the technology, the first pilotless radio controlled aircraft were used in World War I in 1918. The US Army developed the experimental Gettysburg, an unmanned flying bomb aircraft which was never used in combat. The year 1935 was a remarkable when the first generally used drone appeared in 1935 as a full-size retooling of the Havilland DH-82B, the Queen Bee biplane, which was fitted with a radio and servo-operated controls in the backseat. However, the most notable event of the Second World War with regards to the drones was the emergence of the V-1 Doodlebugs of the German Army, fitted with pulse jets. These crafts were effectively the world's first ever cruise missiles. After that, the Vietnam War saw the first use of drones with cameras for reconnaissance. Recreational RC planes became big during the 1960s, thanks to the breakthroughs in the transistor technology at this time. As we moved ahead in times, military drone use solidified in 1982 when the Israel Air Force used UAVs to wipe out the Syrian fleet with minimal loss of Israel force. The Israel UAVs acted as a decoy, jammed communication, and offered real-time video reconnaissance. Drones played a major role. 1990 to 2010 was a pivotal period for military and civilian drone development. Mini and micro versions of UAVs were introduced in 1990, and the famous Predator drone was introduced in 2000. This was used in Afghanistan to launch missiles and in the search of Osama bin Laden. Modern drone. A Wall Street Journal report claims widespread drone use began in 2006 when the US Customs and Border Protection Agency introduced UAVs to monitor the US and Mexico border. In late 2012, Chris Anderson, editor-in-chief of Wired magazine, retired to dedicate himself to his drones company, 3D Robotics. including 3DR. In late 2013, Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos announced a plan to use commercial drones for delivery activities. However, in July 2016, Reno-based startup Flirty beat Amazon to punch, successfully delivering a package to a resident in Nevada via a commercial drone. You have seen how drones has evolved since past. Let's see how drones work. To achieve flight, drones consist of a power source such as a battery or fuel, rotors, propels, and a frame. The frame of a drone is typically made up of lightweight composite materials to reduce weight and increase maneuverability during flight. Drones require a controller which is used remotely by an operator to launch, navigate, and land it. Controllers communicate with the drone using radio waves, including Wi-Fi. To know more in detail about how the drones work, click the link in the description. Type of drones. Let's take a look at what the wide world of a drones has to offer. The list contains both types of consumer drones as well as several different types of military drones which used by the US military. Number 14. Single rotor drones. A single rotor helicopter or other airborne tech project has a greater efficiency than a multi-rotor, but currently fill a small niche in the drone world. Remember the rules of aerodynamics? A single rotor helicopter allows for a longer blades to enable slower spinning and therefore less energy expended. Number 13. Multi-rotor drones. If you want to get your camera into the air for a short period of a time, multi-rotor drone is likely your best bet. A multi-rotor has a distinct advantage for aerial photography due to its excellent control over position and framing for your shots. Rules of aerodynamics dictate that the larger a rotor blade is, the slower it will spin, resulting in more efficiency. That's why a quadcopter is more efficient than an octocopter, but less efficient than a single rotor. Before we proceed on to our next drone, I want you guys to subscribe and share this video with your loved ones. Number 12. Fixed wing drones. The lack of rotors and fixed wing style of these drones make them more similar to controllable airplanes rather than the helicopter style of the other drones. Rather than rotors, their wings provide vertical lift, which means that they only need enough energy to keep moving forward, making them ideal long-range drones. Number 11. Fixed-wing hybrid drones. These type of drones attempt to take the best from fixed-wing and rotor-based designs, making for drones that both feature. A fixed-wing hybrid drone will tend to have a couple of rotors attached to the ends of the fixed wings. Many of these drones are actually based on designs for aircraft that had been around since the 1950s and 1960s. However, the technology to bring them into life was considered too difficult and they were largely shelved before the rise of drones. These units are still rather experimental and so are less commercially available than their single rotor, multi-rotor and fixed wing counterparts. However, with the several companies developing them, they may well be the wave of the future. Number 10. Small drones. These drones are strictly recreational and usually cannot perform many of the commercial functions of which some of those other models are capable. For example, when properly mounted, cameras onboard highly stable, multi-rotor can capture stunning aerial pictures and videos. By contrast, small drones are usually too light and do not have the stability necessary for the picture-perfect balance required for accurate picture taking. Nevertheless, these options can be great inexpensive intro into the world of drones for hobbyists and children. Number 9. Micro drones. While smaller drones may mean recreations in the eyes of the consumers, for militaries who use drones, micro drones are all businesses. The most well-known example of this type of drone in action today is the Black Hornet, manufactured for the British military. Number 8. Tactical drones. These drones are large enough not to be pocket-sized while still being far smaller than the type used for general combat and larger tasks. The preferred tactical drone of the US military is the Raven, which measures 4.5 feet and weighs 4.2 lbs. These type of drones are often used for surveillance work, as with the Black Hornets. The Ravens are capable of being outfitted with the special infrared cameras, helping them supply soldiers with an accurate pictures of the area even in the night time. Number 7. Reconnaissance Drone. With another military drone class, we once again move up in size a bit to drones that are not designed to be handled. Instead, these drones measures around 16 feet long, are launched from the ground and are called medium altitude, long endurance, or high altitude endurance drones. These drones are among the most commonly employed by militaries around the world. The Heron, designed by Israel Aerospace Industries, has manufactured a drone of this nature for military recon used for the US, Canada, Turkey, India, Morocco and Australia. Number 6. Large Combat Drones. Chances are, when you think of drones in a military sense, these are the types you imagine. Variants such as Predator and Reaper used by the US are around 36 feet long and able to fire on targets with air-to-surface missile and laser-guided bombs. These units can operate for 14 hours over a range of 1000 miles. These drones have been used for operations such as military strikes in Pakistan and other countries with which the US is not officially at war. Number 5. Non-combat large drones. By contrast, these are the large drones that are not meant to be used in combat. These can take a variety of jobs, often reconnaissance, and are used for more large-scale recon missions than their minuscule Black Hornet and Raven counterparts. Moving on to number 4, target and decoy drones. One of the most important things to keep in mind about military drones is that they can serve several functions depending on the situations. For example, while some drones can be used for surveillance and others are meant for strike capabilities, these operate as decoys. What these decoys missions looks like, however, is bound to change depending on the individual nature of the mission. As such, these type of military drones must be ready to act as a decoys in any number of ways. Number 3. GPS Drones. Now that we have looked at the major types of drones for the commercial market as well as military use, let's conclude by looking at a few specialty types, starting with drones that are specially designed with GPS purpose in mind. These drones work by linking up to a satellite via a GPS hookup. They are then able to use this as a means of mapping out the rest of their flight, creating data that you can then extract and use for your own purposes. For example, this can be a great way to map out a large topographies. Number 2. Photography Drones. We have already touched on drones' photo-taking capabilities. While a few smaller options can take limited photos, and there are obviously several drones that are capable of doing so for militaries. If you are looking to take professional photos, you will want a commercial drone specially designed to that, as indicated above, to get the kind of stability that is necessary for taking a good picture or videos. You are going to want a drone that feature multiple rotors. Finally, the last in our list, but not the least, the number 1, racing drones. If it has an engine, chances are people will get around to wanting to them to race them, and that's certainly the case with one of these favorite forms of hobbyist-friendly drones. Racing drones can reach speeds up to 60 miles per hour. That said, all of that power concentrated on a single purpose means that they often don't enjoy the same longevity of flight time as their counterparts. Well guys, these were the sum of the drones that has been used till date, but in this changing world, there will be more and advanced drones we could possibly see. Hope you enjoyed this video. Do share this video and see you in the next video.